All right, we're along Route 75. Got dropped off at Spring Run after a night at home. And now we're heading up 75 for 2/10 of a mile. For those of you following the trip the whole way, here at this place is where you start turning up the road towards the mountain. Probably won't do a lot of filming. I got 4 mile road walk. And where you see this greenhouse, you just keep going straight. You'll find the blaze. You come to this juncture in the road, gonna turn left. Alright, we've been road walking for at least 2 miles. Continue straight. As soon as you crest the top, you gotta turn left. As soon as you crest the top, as you look into the sun, you gotta turn left. Well, it's gonna be safe to say that I probably won't be taping much for the next mile or two. I see the Tuscarora Trail in some places hasn't changed in 30 years. I almost basically bushwhacked to this spot, and I'm barely getting going, heading towards the towers above the turnpike. What a mess. Even these seems few and far between. I'm making no miles at all, and having a great time in the briars. Just someone let me know when the fun begins. Folks, I'm not kidding. This is the trail. It's just bushwhack. Like the Standing Stone Trail, the trail just kind of hugs talus slopes, but sometimes you get a view off the talus slope. In this stretch near the turnpike, sometimes you have to resort to the old blazes because it's not, nothing's marked. I have had to, one place I had to bushwhack for 20 minutes to get back on the trail. This is not for the novice. You better know what you're doing when you're doing this section of the T. It's these little climbs that are just the killers. But at least we're getting close to Fannisburg. As you can see, I have blue blazes again. Well, look what we finally found. But you work hard to get this. Very hard. This is Path Valley, and that's the turnpike. And I'm definitely in Buchanan State Forest now, and this trail's gotten much better. It's still got a lot of stuff over, but the conditions and being able to tell where it is excellent. Here's a look back at how nice the trail's become. We're right at the Fannisburg Road. Here's the sign. Tells me where I gotta go. It's 1:30. I don't think I'm gonna stay at the Bird Run Shelter. Should be some good camping along Alwick Creek. Now the 1 mile down to Bird Shelter starts out like this. Okay, we've hit our junction. We're gonna go up. Probably rest for about 2 hours, put the hammock up, take a nap. The spring is running just down from the shelter, but this is June. And here is the Bird Run Shelter. Although it's an odd thing to tape, I do have to say that I definitely appreciate the privies when they're out here in the woods. Thank you, PA. Thank you, PATC. About a mile and a half from the shelter, we now will crossing Alwick Run on this beautiful bridge. And we're going to be crossing the highway, Alwick Highway, real soon. And I'm going to resupply some water. So here's a sign that's dating itself because now it is not the Link Trail. It's the Standing Stone Trail. Already done. Now we're heading to Cowan's Gap. We're going to find a place in the forest to sleep. Well, I'm just a little too late to film it. I watched cubs and a mama knock this baby down, and there was probably 4 cubs. I have my bear spray along, so I'm protected, but they ran off. Couldn't get any video of them, but that trash can just went down, and I watched them do it. That was pretty cool and scary at the same time. And now the Tuscarora shares the path with the very famous old-time trail, the Forbes Trail. Forbes Road, Old Forbes Road. And when I hike the Appalachian Trail, I often ate dinner and then hiked another 2 hours into the evening because sometimes the evening is the best time to be out on the trail. It's a little cooler. All I have to do is throw my hammock up and I'm ready. All right, tonight we're gonna make it work. We're about probably a little more than half a mile outside of Cowan's Gap State Park. Found a cozy spot in the woods to park it for the night. See how it goes. So this ends day 5 on the Tuscarora Trail. All right, good morning. It's 10 to 7. It's launch time on day 2. All right, we've arrived for a very familiar destination for me, probably the second most visited park and the closest state park to my home. We just arrived in Cowan's Gap, 20 after 7. Those of you seeking a different rocky adventure, there's your standing stone trail. This is where it ends, and it's as bad as the Tuscarora, if not more rocky. If you time this better, you could come in and get concessions. That's what happens when I have an early morning start. No hamburgers. All right, for those unfamiliar, you cross Ogwick Road, go through a tiny picnic grove, and up, up, up you go, up Big Mountain. Coming out of Cowan's Gap, you will be going up, 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 but switchbacks are provided, probably because you're in a state park. Another switchback ahead. Just kind of an interesting rock formation at the top of a mountain. Trail has gotten very rocky. Here's a talus slope view, but so hazy already this morning. It's getting close to 8:30. It's supposed to get up into the 90s today. But the one neat thing is I haven't seen a snake on this trail yet. Knock on wood. All right, the Tusky comes out across here. Just dawned on me that I have done this section many times and never in the summer. This looks like tick country, but there's a big mountain in the shelter way up ahead. And you will stay in the high grass for a long time. Hey folks, just to give you a clue of yesterday, this is my left arm. This is my left leg. This is my right leg. And you can see I got damaged up big time. A long stretch of this. It's a nice view looking back. I love this section around the knob as we're heading towards the shelter. Lots of pine. All right, the 0.2 mile side trail takes you to Big Mountain Shelter. I have a kinship with this one because I've stayed the night with both of my sons in this one when they were 6 and 10, now 23 and 27. But this is the Big Mountain Shelter. Okay, now begins the hard climb up to the summit. It's only about 3/10 of a mile up, and it is steep. So I'll be huffing and puffing by the time I get to the overlook. And here is the infamous Big Mountain view. It's been on another one of my videos, my best of the best 5 miles on the Tuscarora Trail. This is a summer view, but it's also a hazy view. And you can drive right up to this. If you do your research, you can drive right up to it. I did it the hard way. I may not do a lot of taping, except for the rocks. This is one of the best areas of the entire Tuscarora. I love this little section here. It just stays on the ridge, winds around Mountain Laurel. Here's a junction with the Charcoal Hogback Trail. That's in another one of my videos. Just take it right here on the Tusky and heads down, built by friends of mine, not by the Forest Service as they claim. All right, this is a set some directions straight. We just came from here. When you get here, do not go up there. That's the plank. Even though there's a blaze there, don't take it. Go straight. Why would I know? Because this is the very track that I do my warm-up hikes in the spring and fall. I do about a 2-2.5 mile loop on the plank trail, which this is what this is. Come out of the forest, go straight. Blaze look like you're gonna make a turn, but you just go straight across this field. Don't you just love these kind of hikes? Right through knee-high grass. When you get to this blaze, keep going straight. The Lincoln Trail goes to your right. You'll be ablaze straight ahead. Just keep walking. And this will take you up to the Ogwit Road. All right, as we come out of the weeds, there used to be the route used to follow. If you can see the blaze on the tree, used to follow down Ogwit Road, made an easy crossing of 30. Now they're gonna take you downhill, so crossing Ogwit Road. It is one steep, rocky descent down to Route 30. There's a fawn. And here is the infamous crossing of 30. I better get going because there's no cars. Now you get to listen to the truck traffic as you go uphill along Route 30. And this is kind of a look back where we came from. Just be keeping your eyes out for the blazes in this section. Definitely an old sign. Now we've arrived at one of the best overlooks on the Tuscarora Trail. This is Fulton County, a large chunk of it. This is where they launch gliders, hang gliders. As you can see, there's the launching pad. We came from up there. Had a beautiful afternoon. Just a ways away, gets you another overlook without any of the man-made stuff in the way. All I can say is no thank you. They've taken the trail from the 90s off the road and have built an actual trail down through here, so I'm kind of impressed. But no thank you. I'd say since they took the trail off the road, this 30 to 16 is actually very pretty, a lot of fern. And a little bit of sun. And here we are at the junction of PA 16, heading down and left.